Good afternoon. Please be seated, everyone. Welcome to the 2023 School of Kinesiology Commencement Ceremony. I'm Pete Bodery, Associate Dean for Undergraduate Education, and I have the great privilege of being your host today. Before we begin the program, as a courtesy to others, please take a moment to silence your cell phones so that we can enjoy the celebration uninterrupted. I would also like to remind guests to please remain in your seats during the awarding of degrees. What an incredible day. Even with the power of ChatGPT, we could not have scripted a more beautiful day. We are thrilled to be in this magnificent auditorium, full of happy, energetic, and proud graduates, surrounded by their family, friends, and our faculty and staff, who are all here to celebrate their success. And we're so excited to have our very special commencement speaker, Dr. Monique Butler, who has a distinguished career in the healthcare industry. Thank you. We're grateful too to Dr. Lori Pierce for being here today. Dr. Pierce is Vice Provost for Academic and Faculty Affairs and Executive Vice President for Academic Affairs at the University of Michigan and a Professor of Radiation Oncology at the University of Michigan Medical School. Thank you so much for joining us today, Dr. Pierce. This will be a ceremony filled with smiles, laughter, and tears, and reminders of how far you have come since your first days on campus and through the challenge of the pandemic. You've had research opportunities, internships, study abroad experiences, clinical rotations, group assignments, and other challenging projects that have added to your academic portfolio. You have enjoyed great social, cultural, and athletic events. And most importantly, you have made friendships that you will cherish forever. This afternoon is about bittersweet endings and exciting new beginnings. You have distinguished yourselves and a population of high-achieving students who have worked hard and accomplished a great deal. Today's event will leave you with many wonderful memories of a celebration shared with family, friends, and the faculty and staff of the School of Kinesiology. We all know that it takes a team effort to make it to graduation day. Graduates, please stand and give your family, friends, and our faculty and staff a round of applause for their support. Our celebration will move along quickly, and at the conclusion of the ceremony, the platform party and graduates will depart immediately to the School of Kinesiology building directly across the street, where there will be plenty of photo opportunities and refreshments. More on this later. And now please rise as Kieran Mangrulker, a senior in the Schools of Kinesiology and Music, Theater, and Dance, sings our national anthem. Please remove your hats and mortarboards.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave? the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Thank you, Karen. That was amazing. Please be seated. It's now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Lori Plaut-Snyder, the Dean of the School of Kinesiology. Dr. Plaut-Snyder became the leader of our school in July of 2016 after her very successful tenure as a professor at Syracuse University, followed by a distinguished career as a lead scientist in exercise physiology at the NASA's Johnson Space Center in Houston. Dean Plaut-Snyder, on behalf of our faculty, staff, and students, I thank you for your leadership over the past 7 years. Please welcome Dean Lori Plaut-Snyder.
Thank you, Dr. Bodery. As Dean of the School of Kinesiology, it is a great pleasure for me to welcome you to this wonderful celebration of our 2023 graduates. I'd also like to take a moment to acknowledge our amazing team. Faculty and staff, please stand. Please be seated. It is a really exciting time to be in our rapidly growing field. We have received the largest number of first-year applications to date in the history of our school, and it's getting even more competitive. Fewer than 20% of the applicants will be accepted for the coming fall semester. The demand to enter our school is rising because of the growth in career opportunities for applied exercise science, athletic training, movement science, and sport management. We're proud to say that Michigan kinesiology graduates in all of our majors and degrees are valued, sought after, and respected. Of course, all of us here today know that Michigan kinesiology students are enthusiastic and successful leaders. Through the 20 different kinesiology student organizations and service groups, our students better their community while building professional relationships that will serve them well into the future. They have won a host of awards, some of which you'll hear about later on in the ceremony, from our school, the university, and even national organizations. Many of our students are international travelers. In the last year alone, we've visited 13 countries, including the Bahamas, Israel, Cyprus, and the Czech Republic. These students have gained significant global experience to enrich their education. They're working as teaching assistants in a wide range of kinesiology classes, conduct research in our school's 28 research centers and laboratories, and publish their work in scholarly journals. Our students have worked on and off campus, competed on athletic and academic teams, excelled in independent study opportunities, and interned with sports organizations, companies, hospitals, clinics, and schools. They are clearly motivated to stay active in all facets of their lives. Our students also leave kinesiology with strong optimism as they begin their next phase. Our movement science graduates often pursue advanced degrees in physical therapy, occupational therapy, medicine, business, social work, psychology, nursing, or public health. Others will begin their career as healthcare workers or researchers. Our athletic trainers will take their conditioning and healing skills to the sidelines of high school, college, or professional sports teams. Some will begin graduate studies in areas like physical therapy, biomechanics, or sports science. Graduate school is also the next step for some of our applied exercise science students. Others will work as health educators, community and corporate wellness providers, performance trainers, using their knowledge to build a healthier community, workplace, and world. A large percentage of our sport management graduates will begin climbing the ladder at sports franchises, media companies, and other corporate organizations. Some will pursue advanced degrees in business, sport administration, or law. All of these students have experienced the Michigan difference, and we know they will see the benefit of their time spent at U of M throughout their careers. I also know that each of you graduates and your families are as proud of your accomplishments here as we, your faculty mentors and advisors, are of you. As you take the next steps in your life, you carry our sincere congratulations and our best wishes with you. So, it is especially fitting that such a great graduating class benefits from the wisdom of our exceptionally accomplished commencement speaker, Dr. Monique Butler. Dr. Butler is the Chief Medical Officer of HCA's Healthcare North Florida Division, where she oversees 15 hospitals, 35 graduate medical education residency programs, and about 1 million patients. Prior to her current role, Dr. Butler served as CMO of HCA's Swedish Medical Center, a 408-bed level 1 trauma center in Colorado. And before that, Dr. Butler was the Chief Operating Officer at Detroit Medical Center and Children's Hospital of Michigan, and CMO at Detroit Receiving Hospital in Sinai Grace Hospital. Now, these are great accomplishments, but the one I'm most proud of is to call Dr. Butler one of our own. So she is a kinesiology alum. In each of these hospital roles, she has reduced readmission and hospital-acquired infection rates while increasing operational efficiency, performance excellence, and patient satisfaction. She earned her bachelor's degree in movement science from Michigan Kinesiology, where she served as the president of kinesiology student government and created the Kinesiology Career Fair, which is still taking place more than two decades later. Dr. Butler later received a medical degree from Wayne State University and an MBA from the University of Tennessee. Throughout her career, Dr. Butler has received numerous awards and accolades, including being named to the Michigan Chronicle 40 Under 40 and the Becker's Hospital Review 50 Great African American Leaders in Healthcare. Her many community service roles include co-founder of the Young Doctors of Detroit program, founder of the Women's Physicians Network, and executive chair of the Greater Detroit Health Council and Cardiac Prevention Program. If that weren't enough, in honor of her late mother, Dr. Butler created the Grant Foundation to help improve health equity in the United States. This includes the Pathfinder Scholarship Award, which will help first-generation and underrepresented Michigan kinesiology students pursue a career in healthcare. Dr. Butler has been married to her husband, Steve, for 20 years and has one daughter in high school. I know Dr. Butler believes that our education and our culture helped her to get where she is today, and so I'm delighted that she's here to share how you too can draw on the values you learned at U of M, even after you've moved on. So please help me welcome our commencement speaker, Dr. Monique Butler.
Thank you. Thank you so very much for the warm introduction, Dean Plout-Snyder. Let me start by thanking you, Dean, and all of the distinguished guests, faculty, trustees of this amazing university. And to the parents, the family, the friends, the brothers, the sisters, who have all helped you and poured great energy into our graduates every step of the way. Let's give them another round of applause. And most importantly, congratulations to the University of Michigan School of Kinesiology, class of 2023. You all look amazing, by the way. I am just ecstatic to be here with the hustle and bustle of graduation weekend and the maize and blue sprinkled throughout the campus. It brings back so many memories. Walking on the dyad, running to catch the Chrysler Arena bus, and the parking tickets. Man, did I have a lot of those. And of course, I think of when I sat in this beautiful auditorium many, many moons ago with so many family and friends as my guests. My two sisters were here back then, and they are both here with me today. Thank you, Colleen and Tracy, for your love and support. I love you. My nephew Kenneth is also here. He's only 9 years old, and he's already a Wolverine at heart. My daughter Brooke is here, but I'll speak to her in just a minute. I was the first in my family to graduate from college, and we were all so excited and proud to celebrate this accomplishment, just as I'm sure each of you are today. As a graduate of one of the most distinguished universities in the world and a notable alum of the University of Michigan School of Kinesiology, you stand ready to continue the profound legacies of service of those who have walked this path to join the ranks of the conquering heroes. I stand here today full of gratitude to congratulate you and to also thank you for accepting the call. As you move forward into the world, I invite you to consider a word you know well. Hail. H-A-I-L. You might think of this word mostly because of our glorious fight song, but each of the letters also has a value attached. Another word that embodies what you've learned here at the University of Michigan. Every time you need to make a difficult decision, think of these words. Let them help you find your way. First, H is for hope. Our world needs your hope now more than ever. In this time of volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity, we need your new vision, not the outdated approaches that persist the world over. We need your grace and your grit to figure out how to solve our greatest problems, your lens of positivity to uplift each other amid crisis. You see, I remember my mom sitting in the back here during my commencement ceremony. She was in a wheelchair fighting the devastating effects of multiple sclerosis. But she was here with a smile that lit up the entire city of Ann Arbor. She had hope for me. She knew I had accomplished so much already as a first-generation college graduate, but she knew that I was capable of even more. She is in heaven now, looking down on us, but she would be absolutely thrilled that I've continued to believe I can have a positive impact on the world. I encourage you to take that same belief forward. Second, the A is for altruism. As leaders and best, it's important that you understand who you are and what you stand for. Excellence starts with a foundation of inclusion, compassion, and respect. We must recognize and affirm the unique and intrinsic worth of each individual. In a world that seems so divided, it is our duty to forge a different path based on trust and empathy. We are ultimately one mankind, one community. We are one. And although humankind deserves equitable treatment, this is not a reality among many populations. I have tried to change that by developing mentoring and shadowing programs for underrepresented students interested in the field of medicine. My husband and I, Stephen, started the Grant Foundation Pathfinders program, named after my mother, to help first-generation and underrepresented Michigan kinesiology students. These are students who may need just a little extra support to get across the finish line so that their moms, too, can watch them graduate. I am certain that each of you will find your own thoughtful ways to bring a kind perspective to your work. And of course, to give back to places like the University of Michigan who have helped you along the way. And then the I in Hail, I believe, stands for intellect. I'm looking at more than 275 leaders who can truly impact the planet. You have answered the call to teach our next generation the importance of physical activity. Many of you will take movement to the next level in building unique, innovative tools to heal those with movement disorders or develop equipment to ensure better functionality for patients with multiple sclerosis like my mother. Some of you will become physical therapists who will help the weak, debilitated patient to regain their steps, or occupational therapists who will provide assistance so patients can get back to activities of daily living and so they can smile again. Others will change the game in the business arena via sports management and communication, or become athletic trainers that provide much needed electricity so fallen athletes can regain their heart rhythm. Me, I chose to be a physician. I am now leading a hospital system as its chief medical officer, ensuring that every patient and family that comes to us receives the highest quality of care possible, no matter what time of the day, no matter what doctor or nurse is caring for them. Back to my daughter, Brooke. She's here with me today. She wants to, one day, be both a Wolverine and a physician, just like me. Right, Brooke? I thought I would use this time to get a full auditorium of witnesses. Just kidding, no pressure, no pressure. Whatever you do, know that there is power in your career choice. Use it to spread knowledge and truth. Finally, the L in Hail, it has to stand for love. Understand that your journey ahead may not always be easy. There will be good days. There will be tough days. I hope for you that the good days will outweigh the tough ones, that the good days will energize you and fill your heart with so much joy. On those good days, you may not rely on this memory today quite as much. But on the tough days, take a deep breath and venture back in your mind to this moment, right here, right now, thinking of what you've accomplished, surrounded by the people who love you. And let it give you the momentum, the determination to hail forward. Hail to the victors. Hail to the conquering heroes. Hail to the leaders and the best. Thank you and congratulations. Let's go blue.
Thank you, Dr. Butler, for your thoughtful and inspiring remarks. I have learned a new strategy to try to embrace my kids' careers, I guess, bring them into Hill Auditorium. So, Brooke, I hope that was not too much for you. Our program continues with our first student speaker, Mei Chow, who is receiving a master's degree in sport management.
Dear fellow graduates, esteemed faculty members, and distinguished guests, I'm Mei Chow from the Sport Management Master Program. It's an absolute pleasure to stand before you today on this beautiful afternoon as we celebrate our graduation from the School of Kinesiology. As we embark on a new chapter in our life, I want to ask a question. What does success mean to you? I believe each one of us has our own unique answer. For me, success simply means being happy no matter where I'm at. Today, I'd like to share how I've achieved my own definition of success throughout my journey here at U of M for the past year. I learned to embrace my own uniqueness. In Taiwan, where I grew up, there were only limited ideas of success. In order to be successful there, you have to be an accountant, a lawyer, or a doctor. Before coming to Michigan, I could merely thought of myself as a numbers person, an accountant. I was really afraid of trying something different. But my experience at Michigan helped me realize it's okay to be different. It really helped me find out what I loved and what I was interested in. And more importantly, I was encouraged again and again to share my opinion. Now, I embrace my own uniqueness, and I am amazed how much value I can bring. I can confidently say that I will follow my passion and use my expertise to make a positive impact on the sport industry. My goal is to create the nonprofits that connect young athletes in Taiwan with education opportunities, because it is common in Taiwan for young athletes to focus more on their sports careers than their schooling. So I will create education opportunities for them and help them to translate their skills to other careers if they don't become professional athletes. I believe as long as you are tracing your own dream and doing what you enjoy, that feels so good. As an international student, I've been presented with the unique opportunity to experience the diversity and richness of the Michigan community. I've learned that this community is a constant flow. It's continuous, like a stream, which flows before me, continue to flow when I step in, and it will keep flowing when I step out. I vividly remember the first day of the orientation. One of the professors said, "My LinkedIn profile is your LinkedIn profile." I was confused then. But now I understand that we are all part of this community, and we will remain part of this community for the rest of our lives. Congratulations, class of 2023. Go Blue! Thank you. And now I would like to welcome Zachary to the podium.
How are we doing, graduates? Doing all right? All right. Leaders in Best. That's how I began my application letter to the University of Michigan over 4 years ago. In high school, I had carved leadership roles for myself in everyday life at school and with my family, where I was the oldest of eight. I was a captain for two sports teams and paving my way for a career in sport broadcasting. I had grown up a fan of U of M. Whenever the football team was on the road, I would listen to broadcasts of the games and just dreamed of doing the same thing someday. At first, though, it didn't really seem like Michigan felt the same way. I got a deferral letter, and shortly thereafter, I got my official denial from the university. Well, at the time, I was heartbroken. I fell into a period where I didn't know where to go or what to do. Like so many of us, over the next couple of years, I had to be resilient. For me, it was grinding through a year elsewhere at the University of Michigan Flint, and then entering the academic transfer portal to earn a spot at my dream school. For others, it was moving away from home for the first time and eventually battling a year shut down by the pandemic, combating mental health, and for some, losing loved ones. A year that we missed out on the social aspect of going to school. A year with quiet lecture halls, lonely streets, and an eerily empty big house. I listened to a speech from Hal Elrod, a best-selling author who was in a car accident in 1999. He told a story about how he was driving home from giving a speech and he was hit by a drunk driver. His car then flipped into oncoming traffic and was then hit by another vehicle. For 6 minutes, his heart stopped beating. He woke up from a coma 6 days later. He was told he would never walk again. After that, Hal said, "I accept that I may never walk again, and I'm at peace with that, but I am not deciding that's my only option." He said, "The doctors may be experts in medicine, but they are not experts in me." 3 weeks later, Hal defied the odds. He rose to his feet, and he proved the experts wrong. Now, I'm telling you this because you will be put in a position to overcome adversity. What exactly are you going to do when you don't get that dream job out of the gate? What are you going to do when it feels like your goals may be set too high? What are you going to do when tragedy sets in? And life? Well, life can get that much more real. Times like these, they teach us to become resilient, to battle, to scratch and claw, to be a conquering hero. Now, the ability to show resilience is equally important to your success as that 8 a.m. economics exam we all crammed for last minute. Now, I implore each and every one of you to push your own limits, because if you don't, you'll never know what they are. If I didn't go to Michigan, I wouldn't have a shot at my dream job now in the future. I'm proud to call this university home, and I hope you all are too. Because like the great James Earl Jones puts it, and I hope everyone here will join me in saying, we are the best university in the world. Thank you, and go Blue. I would now like to welcome Elizabeth Enselman to the podium.
Thank you, Zach. Hi, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Enselman, and I'm the chair of the Kinesiology Alumni Society Board of Governors. On behalf of the entire board, congratulations on your graduation. It is my honor to welcome you as the newest members of the Kinesiology Alumni Society. We hope that you will all continue to be strong, loyal, contributing alumni in the years to come, and stay connected to the School of Kinesiology through its program-specific LinkedIn groups and Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram feeds. Many of you have received the direct benefit of alumni networking and connections for jobs and internships. In fact, I've already met many of you via social media, networking events, and emails. I'm sure you understand the firsthand value of these golden alumni networking opportunities. Career service support is an essential component of the Alumni Board's mission and the School of Kinesiology's Career Development Center. I urge you to take advantage of your post-graduation first-year discounted membership to the university's Alumni Association. Enroll online to receive all the benefits. You are now part of one of the largest living alumni families. On behalf of the entire Kinesiology Alumni Society, congratulations to you, the class of 2023. Go Blue, and welcome to the Kinesiology and University of Michigan Alumni Societies. I would like to invite Annabelle Ha to the podium.
Thank you, Ms. Enzelman. Good afternoon, and thank you all for being here to celebrate with us today. My name is Annabelle Ha, and I'm the president of Kinesiology Student Government, an organization dedicated to improving the kinesiology student experience. It is my honor this evening to present the 2022-2023 Student Excellence in Teaching Awards. These awards give students the opportunity to recognize School of Kinesiology graduate student instructors, lecturers, and full-time faculty for their meaningful contributions to the lives of students at the school. Kinesiology students nominate individuals, and a committee of kinesiology student organization leaders select the winners. The recipients are chosen based on their superior classroom teaching and innovative instruction, their dedication to challenging their students to learn and explore educational and professional opportunities, and their concern for students in and outside of the classroom. Our first award winner is Clinical Associate Professor Dr. Laura Richardson. Our students said, Dr. Richardson is fairly new to UM, but has already made an impact on so many. She was the kindest, most understanding professor I have had in my time at U of M. She would always assess our comfort level with her curriculum and base her teaching objectives on how the students felt. She made sure we understood the material and encouraged us to be the best we could be in her class. She asks how we are and what we are up to outside of school and is constantly offering opportunities for us to hone our skills and learn more outside of class. I am grateful for Dr. Richardson and all she does for students. I would like to invite Dr. Richardson to the podium to accept her Excellence in Teaching Award. Congratulations, Dr. Richardson. Our second award winner is Clinical Assistant Professor, Dr. Tom George. Our students said, Dr. George is so accommodating to the students and awesome at teaching our classes. SM 437 is so interesting, and I love his passion for the subject. I have had two applied exercise science courses with Dr. George, and in each, he has helped us apply the skills that we have learned in the classroom to the real world. I will never forget juggling in my motor control course. He has helped me with all of my needs and guided me in the right direction to succeed. He is always willing to give advice about the industry and pushes us to be, as students, to be our best. I would like to invite Dr. George to the podium to accept his Excellence in Teaching Awards. Congratulations, Dr. George. Our third award winner is Clinical Assistant Professor Ron Wade. Our students said, Professor Wade is always there for his students and genuinely cares for them. He is always willing to help us both in and out of the classroom by giving us advice for entering the industry and teaching us strategies that will help us thrive early on in our careers. His expertise is vast and his class is always engaging, even though it's at 8:30 a.m. His teaching style is interesting and impactful, so content is easy to learn, and his class activities, such as our field trip to a Detroit Pistons game, allows for valuable application to the sports industry. I would like to invite Professor Wade to the podium to accept his Excellence in Teaching Awards. Our fourth and final award winner is graduate student instructor, Michelle Marinas. Our student said, Michelle is an amazing person to work with and was always on top of her game in and outside of the classroom. As someone who is interested in continuing on to graduate school for research, I've benefited from Michelle's mentorship. Her experience has been very helpful in my own professional development. Michelle sets healthy work-life boundaries while still working hard to ensure a positive experience for her students. She truly cares about their learning. I would finally like to invite Michelle to the podium to accept her Excellence in Teaching Awards. Congratulations, Michelle. Congratulations once again to all the recipients of this year's Students Excellence in Teaching Awards. I would now like to welcome Dr. Greg Cartee to the podium. But before I conclude, I want to congratulate my fellow graduates of the class of 2023. I wish you the best of luck in all of your future endeavors, and forever, go blue!
Thank you, Annabelle. I appreciate it. And my name is Greg Cartee. I'm the Associate Dean for Research. And as you likely know, research makes up an integral part of the academic experience in the School of Kinesiology. And we encourage our students to take advantage of the many opportunities available to them throughout their studies. For example, graduate and undergraduate students may complete a thesis while working closely with a faculty member on a specific research problem. I would like to take this opportunity to acknowledge those students who have completed a research thesis this year. Students, please stand as I call your name. I ask the audience to hold their applause until all names have been announced. Jordan Rashi completed a movement science honors thesis entitled Effects of High Definition Transcranial Direct Current Stimulation on the frontal parietal network and manual dexterity. Say that three times. Brandon Albedri completed a senior thesis entitled The Relationship Between Employee Physical Activity Intensity and Workplace Burnout. Congratulations all. And now, for the moment you have been waiting for, the graduates themselves. I'd like to ask Ms. Inselman to take her position on stage. Students, remember to receive your pen from Ms. Inselman and pause for a photo at the end of the stage before returning to your seat. Kinesiology confers degrees in the following areas: Doctor of Philosophy, Master of Science, Bachelor of Arts, and Bachelor of Science. We begin with granting our doctoral degrees. The following descriptions I'll be reading represent a synopsis of the dissertation project that each of the doctoral graduates have completed under the supervision of a graduate faculty mentor. Dr. Stephen Broglio, Associate Dean for Graduate Affairs, will assist in the hooding of our graduates along with their faculty advisors. Whitney Wolf and Dr. David Lipps, please join Dr. Broglio. Whitney Wolf's dissertation is titled The Influence of Idiopathic Chronic Neck Pain on Sternocleidomastoid and Upper Trapezius Muscle Activity and Elasticity. Her doctoral research establishes the neuromuscular and mechanical adaptations associated with idiopathic chronic neck pain during assessments of functional, reaching, and seated computer work ergonomics. Whitney's high-quality manuscripts were published in leading biomechanics journals, including the Journal of Biomechanics and the Journal of Electromyography and Kinesiology. She received numerous awards and honors for her graduate work, including the Paul A. Hunsicker Memorial Award, the Lucille M. Swift Honors Award, the Zatkoff Family Fellowship, and external funding from the DeLuca Foundation and the American Society of Biomechanics. In addition to her research accomplishments, Whitney was a dedicated instructor in biomechanics courses in our movement science program and received certificates in graduate teaching and in diversity, equity, and inclusion. Whitney is now a teaching assistant professor in the Department of Kinesiology and Community Health at the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. Congratulations, Dr. Wolf. Congratulations. Gon Ji and Dr. Kate Heinze, please join Dr. Broglio. Gon Ji's dissertation is titled Professional Sports Teams Community Engagement During an Environmental Jolt, Shifting Activities and State Differences Amid the COVID Pandemic. Gon's research focuses on sports organizations' responses to changes in the field. Gon's scholarship and professional promise have been recognized by several awards. She received the Lucille Swift Honors Award and the Paul Hunsicker Memorial Award. Gon also earned a Rackham Fellowship. After graduation, Gon will pursue a faculty position that allows her to contribute to education and research in sport management. Congratulations, Dr. G. Please join me now in once again congratulating our newly minted doctoral graduates. I will now turn the stage over to Doug Tribou, the host of Morning Edition on Michigan Radio, the public radio network based here at U of M. He will announce the master's and bachelor's degree graduates.
Thank you, Dr. Carty. I'd like to ask Dr. Brian Syka to take his position on the stage to congratulate the Master of Science Athletic Training graduates. Students, as you cross the stage, remember to shake your faculty member's hand, receive your pin from Ms. Enselman, and pause for a photo at the far end of the stage before returning to your seat. Jacqueline Kluge. Peyton James. Jenna Bethany Miller. Rosalie Elizabeth Mumford. Jessica Von Arks. Alyssa Lauren Bolt. Lauren Cimino. Montana Elizabeth Windham. Gabriella Von Arks. Aaron Gerwig. I'd like to ask Dr. Steve Broglio to take his position on stage to congratulate the Master of Science Movement Science graduates. Anthony Lewis Summers. Seth Cahan. Anna Panabianco. Sarah Mackenzie Price. Barrett Philip Bongiorno. Grayson Edward Hill. Robert Wesley Salaver. I'd like to ask Dr. Kathy Babiak to take her position on stage to congratulate the Master of Science Sport Management graduates. Justin Matthew Vagnosi. Lorenza Guzman Henschel. Janice Danielle Packnett. Haun Gloria Nam. Mei Chow. Denki U Ung. Anthony Charles Gattino. Declan Lewis Gaffney. Ari Eisen. Abigail Wickle. Amy Sias. Christian Yuri. Crayley Ledger. Nicholas DeMarco. I'd like to ask Dr. Tom George and Dr. Laura Richardson to take their positions on stage to congratulate the Bachelor of Science Applied Exercise Science graduates. Benjamin Gary Jacobs. Zoe Norman. Elena Grace D'Souza. Annabelle Ha. Ellen Pretz Baker. Olivia MacArthur Van Dyne. London Taylor Yancey. Stephanie Ibarra. Marquise Isaiah DeLong. Mohammed Nuraini Dinky Abdo. Jordan Anne-Marie Walker. Jackson Ray Dell. Micah Gelb. Caroline Nicole Gastworth. Sophia DeStefano. Nicoletta Koulos. Amber Elizabeth Beals. Jessica Merzik. Christian Joseph Ferrante. Kendall Brown. Lily Grace Ammons. Michael Connor. Jameson Biskner Cruzy. Adam Carey. I'd like to ask Dr. Ryan Palmieri Smith to take her position on stage to congratulate the Bachelor of Science Athletic Training graduates. Dominique Duc Doi Tran. Charles Robert Runstrom. Claire Roleader. Brian John Pitts. Taylor Potter. K. Caitlin Zielinski. Juan Sancho Martinez. Braden James Hinkston. Lindsay Coggins. Valerie Kaler. Emily Addison Hudson. I'd like to ask Dr. Kara Palmer to take her position on stage to congratulate the Bachelor of Science Movement Science graduates. Abigail May. Lauren Clark. Summer McEvers. Maxwell Camara. Evan Hickman. Pingyang Tai. Juliana King. Lauren Claire Hart. Katie Hyde. Grace Brenner. Noelle Bedard. Brittany Elizabeth Andrews. Fatima Faye Habibovich. Gabriella Craner. Shane Dolan. Nathan Smith. Janelle Diana DeBakke. Taylor Renee Everson. Vanessa Ruiz. Eliana Israel. Ashley Jung. Davi Foster Lupovich. Grace Allor. Daniel Fisher Coolier. Isabel Francesca Pensilla. Emma Moore. Gurnordeep Parwar. Tess Louise Davis. Taylor Hooker. Annika D. Samantha Christine Wyans. Eden Nicole Buell. Liyun Ma. Gabriel Heilman. Leanna Lynn Burns. Megana Sai Mulpuri. Abigail Liu. Shiwei Dong. Divya Banu Padala. Caroline Rose Tilly. Elise Madeline Walker. Elena Renke. Lauren Haller. Sam Ryan Russo. Sophia Margaret McSpedden. Paloma Johnson. Leah Vicutis. Colette Donlin. Elizabeth Rose Zucker. Andrew Phillips. Lama Douglas. Rohan Sishdeva. Ryan Christopher Breen. Brandon Albedri. Christian DeLuca Pulselli. Josue Gonzalez. Tanner Thomas Trineri. Noah Robert Meyer. Sydney Dawn Farley. Lillian Rose Bombach. Erica Williams. Hannah Elizabeth Greshak. Catherine Dajung Kim. J.P. Arslanian. James Ha. Daniel Che. Christopher Moy. Caitlin Nicole Besser. Amelia Ann Wright. Emma Peterson. Shruti Ramamurti. Olivia Tu. Baylor Wiggins. Sharior Mirzaev. Anthony Zhang. Austin Kim. Steven Sterlitz. Abud Alsubi. Hussein Mustafa. Alec McKean. Jacob Sawicki. Ava Thrasher. Jaden Taylor Bogard. Octavia Lau. Ava Louise Morales. I'd like to ask Mr. Josh Murgos to take his position on stage to congratulate the Bachelor of Science Movement Science graduates who have completed an intraoperative neuromonitoring concentration. Annika Dreisma. Kira Shagru. Nicholas Joseph Loparino. Tessa Labine. Elizabeth Ann Miller. Adeza Emmanuel Njoku. Ashley and Didi Abugane Akaba. Jacqueline Gail Spelta. Ayush Mayunk Patel. Brooke Reamer. Brianna Sukert. Mavish Sophia Malik. Pia Garg. Jackson Henning. I'd like to ask Dr. Mark Rosentraub and Ms. Kelly Donahue to take their positions on stage to congratulate the Bachelor of Arts Sport Management graduates. Blake Corum. Nikai Hill Green. Max Spencer Wittenberg. Jacob Austin Cohen. Caleb Posner. Nicholas Robert Darnoy. Tanner Pavick. Joseph Shapiro. Jack Mindell. Jacob Scott Weitzman. Samuel Henry Rogers. Kobe Bernstein. Cameron Robert Peel. Isaac Broniak. Zachary Christian Yaksich. Bryson Duffield. Andy Yee. Joshua Sungho Taubi. Andrew Hatton. Alexander Wells Ferguson. Benjamin Aldrich. Peter Nicholas Grobel. Bailey Michael Warner. Cody Raymond Carlson. Yi Zhang. Evan Scott Jaeger. Joshua McLaren. Austin Gannell. Charles Francis Tooley. Sean Davis. Antonio Flores. Ian Barrett. Nicholas Matthew John Van Hecken. Jillian Mariah Thorpe. Allison Paige Johnston. Jessica Marie Garman. Sophia Marie Rollis. Kendall Paige Brown. Jalen Claxton. Christopher Hill. Benjamin Mark Moss. Ethan Jesselson. Samantha Post. Rachel Negri. Anna Wernick. Samantha Faith Langford. Emily Hope Ross. Haley Rosenberg. Charlie Patriga. Ashley Elizabeth Wuthrick. Sabrina Dempsey. Bryson Scott Shello. Hannah Shapiro. Ella Ansel. Jacob Garner. Jared Brecker. Chasen Greenfield. Ouyang Shu. Jessica Morshikov. Ian George Sheets. Madeline Jacobs. Canon Furuyama. Natalie Ziegler. Brandon Seaton Trachtenberg. Zehan Batlivala. Hallie Zlotnick. Hannah Bliss Janowski. Alexa Ostreger. Jordan Emily Rickard. Jacob Kluger. Yes, Xander Brooks. Stephen Ross Becker. Benjamin Aiden Lubowitz. Spencer Goldberg. Harrison Stephen Pithers. Max Dylan Kramer. Aiden Tanner Scott. Michael Angelo Ziola. Michael John Skinian. Georgia Myers. Devon Anuj Gupta. Timothy John Fox. Elizabeth Grace Murphy. Sophia Perry. Zach Corson. Alana Renee Milo. Ellie Yarmy. Evan Williams. Camilla Sobers. Emma Kachula. Aaron Cruz del Rosario Latham. Devin Wisniewski. Dominic Shipp. Stevie McGregor. Diego Andrade Cabrera. Daniel Abul Hassan. Shane Alexander Videcki. Austin Robert Karnick. Jesse Brandon Stein. Zeke Rosenblatt. Jonathan Xavier Moore. Yipong Wong. Cole Lightfoot. Ethan Ward Guthrie. Garen Ladig. Ryan Matthew Lechtner. Ryan Jackson Kraus. Aaron Maloney. Zach Linfield. All of these students have completed the degree requirements as prescribed by the faculty of the School of Kinesiology. Dean Plautz Snyder, it is my honor to present to you the graduates of the class of 2023.
Thank you, Mr. Tribou. Graduates, please stand. When you put your cap and gown on today, your tassel should have been placed on the right side, signifying you had not yet graduated. On behalf of the Board of Regents of the University of Michigan and the faculty and staff of the School of Kinesiology, I congratulate you on your graduation this evening. Please move your tassels now from the right to the left. Done. And now I'll turn the podium over to Dr. Bodery one last time.
Congratulations, graduates. I think Ann Arbor will always be your home away from home, and you will forever be a proud part of the history of the School of Kinesiology and the University of Michigan. You are joining the largest team at the University of Michigan, more than 600,000 alumni throughout the world. To our graduates, may you always uphold the excellent tradition that defines Michigan alumni and the Michigan difference. Again, on behalf of the faculty and staff, thank you for enriching our lives, and good luck and congratulations to you, the class of 2023. In just a moment, we will conclude our ceremony with song. But first, I need to provide you with some final instructions. After we sing, we ask that you all remain seated at the platform as the platform party recesses. The marshals will then dismiss the graduates row by row. Families and guests should remain in their seats as the graduates depart for the reception at the School of Kinesiology building directly across the street from here. You'll see the tent on the left side of the building right before the flagpole. See page 3 of your program for a map. Please stand and join Kieran, who will lead us in singing the yellow and blue. Kieran will then lead us in singing the victors. The words for both songs are on page 3 of your program.